My friends, the information that you are about to witness from all of my years of research is the most important. It's been hidden in plain view the entire time. This is the ultimate secret.
Every day, our senses are being constantly bombarded by subliminal messages that are found in TV, movies, and advertisements. The subliminal messages we are subjected to are unrecognizable by the conscious mind and only recognizable in our subconscious mind. The messages and imagery are passively absorbed and then stored in our subconscious, where propagandists deliberately implant artificial thoughts, which in turn can affect our actions and attitudes later in life. Experiments have shown that less than 1 minute after the viewer begins to watch television, the brain switches from beta-level consciousness, associated with active and logical thought, to alpha-level, which is associated with passive acceptance and suggestibility. This is why advertisers spend billions of dollars a year on commercials, as well as product placement within TV shows. Political messages are implanted in fictional TV programs as the relaxed meditative state of the viewer is receptive to the programming. One example is AMC's Breaking Bad television series, as it depicts a meth villain as a Ron Paul supporter.
I looked him up. It was one of these physicists, one of Hitler's guys, a physicist named Werner Heisenberg. Real cute, huh?
In a basic college-level marketing class, in your first year of radio, television, and film, at least for me, and then I've seen some other textbooks and curriculum and found it's also in those, but most RTF schooling teaches you that they have had subliminals for at least 70 years in the United States and Europe. And so, yes, there is subliminal messaging everywhere. It is all over the place. It's an absolute fact that they flicker it at a rate and that they have the televisions designed for that rate to bring you into a dreamlike state. I mean, it is a fact that within minutes, you go into a dream brainwave when watching television. Go read a book by the father of modern advertising, Edward Bernays, where he calls you a dumb slave and admits they run your whole life. I've read both his major books. One of them is called Propaganda. Edward Bernays.
The conscious and intelligent manipulation of the organized habits and opinions of the masses is an important element in democratic society. Those who manipulate this unseen mechanism of society constitute an invisible government, which is the true ruling power of our country. We are governed Our minds are molded, our tastes are formed, our ideas suggested, largely by men we've never heard of. This is a logical result of the way in which our democratic society is organized.
Now, I also mentioned, too, that a fellow that has been in touch with me for an awful long time, his brother was in the CIA, or is in the CIA. He will never talk about the CIA to him. He'll never give anything away whatsoever, except one bit of advice. He said, never watch the television. Never watch the television. It's the greatest scientific indoctrination tool ever devised. Haven't you figured that out? It's changed the whole culture of nations, not just one nation. Why do you think it was mandatory that everybody in Britain give access to televisions by the government? Why do you think China is under the same program to get everyone with a TV right now? Because they love to have you entertained. Do you really think that? And India is on the same route as well right now too. Most of your ideas and your opinions and how you emulate, because you emulate things, you mimic what you see, as Charles Galton, Darwin and others have said in the past. It becomes you, you become it. And that's what's happened. It's been very, very, very successful. Never watch the television. You can't watch a movie unless you do it critically, if you watch it critically. Not there to enjoy it. Remember what they say, it's your emotions that get you on. And it's interwoven, all these emotional themes, all through movies. You're played like a harp. And they embed ideas in you, into you, along with the movies. And predictive programming too, so you'll accept that which is still to come. And you'll behave the same way as the characters in the movie when it comes. Oh well, what can you do? I'll just watch much music or television. Yeah. You're given a mind of your own, and you've got to use it for yourself.
Mind control is one of the tools that they use. How they get you in the condition to be controlled is by using certain signs and symbols, frequencies, tones, colors, shapes, numbers that they hide subconsciously in the frequency of the music and in the 23rd frame, I believe, on TVs and the movies. Look at the movie-going experience. We go in and we buy butter, popcorn, and Coke. You're actually buying cocaine, and you're buying this chemical called popcorn. Why do I call it a chemical? That butter is not really butter. But when you put it on the popcorn and you put it in the microwave, it becomes a chemical that lulls your subconscious mind to sleep. Inducing you and lulling you to sleep, so by the time you walk into a dark movie theater, you're already prepped. You're laying there, you're damn near dozing off. You're focusing in on a screen in the dark with the surround sound, and they're attacking your subconscious mind with frequencies and images. Go to The Arrivals on YouTube. The Arrivals. A-R-R-I-V-A-L-S. The Arrivals. Go to number 10 and watch it through number 12, and you'll see exactly how they pull this off. When you leave the movie theater, you're almost punch drunk. You leave the movie theaters with your breast filled, wanting to be the hero, or wanting to be the damn damsel in distress, wanting to be a corny white girl to fall down in every damn horror flick. Are you following me? So we have to understand it. So now to the small screen, they keep the small screen filled with nonsense. Channel Zero, I wrote a song with Public Enemy. Channel Zero is what we call it, which actually amounts to absolutely nothing. I don't care if it's the daytime stories or the unreality shows or MTV Cribs, Pimp My Ride, or whatever. Absolutely nonsense.
If you watch cable, don't do it, because one of the implementations is the box that you have to get for your cable TV. And that is one of the ways that they have found out that certain sound waves can control you.
So there are sound waves.
Oh, bro. Yeah.
There's sound waves that come out of the cable box.
No, that comes out of your TV.
That come out of your TV.
That they can tweak it. They can tweak it to where they can make you feel sad, they can make you feel glad. You know how people have those super harmonious CDs, they pop it and they feel good.
Yeah. Oh.
It's just great. It's the exact same thing.
Exact same thing.
And it's very simple. It's very cheap. It works.
And you, and you pay a monthly premium for it.
It's a very simple equation here. They control by controlling the information that people receive. If we are going to, and we are in the process of dismantling this, then alternative information that tells the truth about the movie and exposes it needs to get out there. Mm-hmm. Now, everyone has got a mouth. Everyone. And everyone's got a voice box, or virtually everyone. And therefore, we can articulate and pass this on. And so, it's ridiculous to say there's nothing we can do. We can get onto radio phone-ins, radio shows that don't talk about this, and bring those issues into the debate. I think they've realized that there is a challenge coming here, and people are, in increasingly vast numbers, are so open to this. I tell you what it is. This is why it's so important to communicate this stuff. Is the number of people who come across this information that didn't know it existed, and they go, "Do you know, I've thought that was going on. I've always thought that." But they haven't talked about it. And then they realize that their friends thought like that too, but they haven't talked about it either. We need to start communicating this, and then we'll realize just how many people out there are actually of like mind.
Visions of Martin Luther staring at me. Malcolm X put a hex on my future, someone catch me. I'm falling victim to a revolutionary song. The Serengeti's clone. Back to put you backstabbers back on your spinal bone. You slit your disc when I slit you my disc. You wanted to diss but jumped on my grown. Man never should bite their tongue unless you eat that smell like it's a stale plum. Visions of Martin Luther staring at me. If I see it, I ain't seen it. That would make my parents happy. Sorry, mama, I can't turn the other cheek. They wanna knock me off the edge like a f***ing widow's peak, And she always told me pray for the weak, Them demons got me, I ain't prayed in some weeks, Dear Lord, come save me, the devil's working on. He probably clocking double shifts, so none of his jobs.
Satan knows that secular songs glorifies sin, because while you're listening to it, sin is on your mind, like lust, partying.
It's that time of the week, she like to freak a leak and get naughty. Therefore, I like to thank God and Ice Cube for Friday, cause la-di-da-di.
Drinking, smoking, violence,
I ain't never touched a gas that I couldn't shoot,
and rage.